Thank you, viewers, for joining us again. Today I'm with Comrade Gwisai. We are discussing over the recent held Congress. So the next question, Comrade Gwisai, that I'm going to ask you is that, is this still the MDC of 1999 that ISO helped form, you being the leading member?
No, clearly not, because as I've said, that the party obviously did, spoiled over 2 million, swept most of the town's urban seats and councils, just like what happened in 2000. But the structure of the leadership of the party, the ideology of the party, the purpose of the party, and who the party serves, not anymore. It has become the opposite. The party was formed to fight the Mugabe dictatorship, which was imposing a horrendous economic structure adjustment program, which is very similar to what Mnangagwa, Chiwenga and Mutuli are now doing under their transitional stabilization program, the TSP. And it was led by workers, by working people. Now, this is different. If you just look at the presidium of the party that was elected at the MDC Congress, Chamisa president, Chamisa is now a lawyer himself, an advocate. You have Tendai Biti, another leading lawyer, Wosh Mengue, another leading lawyer. Then you have Miss Kore as the presidium of four people. One is problematic itself. When the MDC was formed, it only had one vice president one president, Changirai and Sivanda, because one of the demands of the people is that there's too much wastage of national resources, government money, by the patronage system that Mugabe built with two vice presidents. Yet the MDC now has three vice presidents. Yet, despite the fact that the MDC has three vice presidents, one and a president, three of those are middle class elites who represent interests that you do not have any trade unionist in that presidium, in a party where the presidium used to be completely dominated by trade unionists. Then if you look in the standing committee itself, that is their top body of about 10, 11 people, you probably, what I can see, are probably two or three trade unionists. That is Tabitha Kumalo, as the chairperson of the party. And then you have Mpariwa Paulina as the leader of the women's assembly. So two, maximum three trade unionists out of 11. So completely changed over. Komichi, who was a founding chairperson of the MDC in 1999-2000, and is a trade unionist from the energy industry, was thrown out. And if indeed you want to see how bad the situation has become, Komichi had been nominated by 11 provinces out of 13 MDC provinces. Yet, Komichi is the one who was defeated. And it's not a surprise. It's not a surprise because as an ordinary trade union leader, worker, he could not and does not have the money to compete against money bags like Wosh Mengue, Tendai Biti, and so forth. These are elites who have made money because of their service to big business. They are not their service not even to big business, even to the ZANU-PF regime. If you take Wosh Mengue, he donated ostensibly 10 cattle at the Congress because Wosh Mengue donated quite a number of, quite a tonnage of maize. Wosh Mengue was given a farm by Mugabe, the Jamanja farms. Yet they expelled ISO. I was expelled as an MP for MDC. The first two charges were that I was supporting, and the ISO were supporting the land reform program. That land should go to the people, which was consistent with the founding values of the MDC. In the MDC, we had said that 7 million hectares of land should be given to peasants. At that time, ZANU was saying 5 million. Yet when white commercial farmers, the likes of Bennett, when the British, when the American imperialists came on board, the MDC then flipped over and opposed the land reform program. Yet people like Wosh Mengue who was the general secretary of the party and who wrote the letter to expel us, he himself got a farm. These are also the very same lawyers who represent ZANU-PF, corrupt ZANU-PF cronies who have destroyed this country. Welsh Mengume is the lawyer for the former vice president, Mpoko. Mpoko spent 2 years eating public money, staying at the Sheraton, and to get out after demonstrations. Yet the person who represents him today, that he'd be given even more money, is Welsh Mengume. Tendai Biti, as the general secretary of the MDC, used to say to the masses that Gideon Gono, the former Reserve Bank governor, was a financial terrorist worse than Al Qaeda, and that he should be put on the wall and be shot by a firing squad for his corruption. Gideon Gono, who destroyed the lives of workers, the lives of peasants and ordinary people through his bearer checks, and supervised and presided over a massive looting spree by ZANU-PF. Yet, when he was brought before the court for corruption, his lawyer is Tendai Biti. I could go on and on. Many of these leading MDC civic society lawyers represent. Now, so they make money from this. And we also know that these people are supported by big business. They are supported by Western capitals. You saw the American Foreign Committee of the American Congress say that, demand that Tendai Biti could not be brought before thing. The courts of this country literally could not have jurisdiction over his matter. So and these are also the very same people that we know went to campaign for sanctions, a strengthening of sanctions. So you can't then say these people will represent the interests of ordinary people. These are elites who have shown serious anti-working people ideas, tendencies, and practices. These are people who are also opportunists, as I've already said. How do you stand and say to the masses of this country and the world that this country has been destroyed by ZANU-PF corruption, yet you are at the forefront of being paid by those same crooks as their lawyer? This kind of opportunism is not the first time that lawyers have been involved in politics. In the anti-colonial struggle, we had lawyers like Herbert Chitepo, Edson Stole, Edson Zobo. Yet, not a single instance did you ever see those nationalist lawyers represent Rhodesian fascists. Similarly, in South Africa, you had lawyers like Nelson Mandela, O.R. Tambo, Robert Sobukwe. All these were nationalist, pan-Africanist lawyers. Never did you see them represent apartheid goons in the courts. In fact, they were jailed for their beliefs. So the MDC, in terms of its leadership, has changed. Workers and trade unions are losers in terms of what has happened. They now talk about giving them some legal quarters. Vaeni ndo vaakupavaridzi vepati kuganhura kuti batai apa. Varivo vaenzi vapinda mumba vaakutotora imba zvose vakuita zvavanoda. And then, crucially, the ideology of the party has changed. I've said to you, we as socialists supported, fought for this for the establishment of the party. In fact, if you read the Changirai's book called The Deep End, Changirai says in the book that initially, big business was not prepared to join the party. He says there was only quoted and cross, was not prepared to join the party because they thought that the MDC was a socialist communist party. And he says that they had that image because, people like myself and other members of the ISO were members, and they felt that the MDC was influenced by socialists. I've already said that the ideology of the party was based on what was called radical social democracy. That means overturning Mugabe's economic structural adjustment program, ensuring that you use public funds, you use the state to ensure that there are price controls, to ensure that there are subsidies in terms of basic commodities, farm inputs, to ensure that there's quality public health funded by the state, quality education from primary to university funded by the state, to ensure that we build roads, dams, we electrify our rural areas.
Mm.
And we do that by taking money from the big capitalists, from the multinationals who are taking our gold, who are taking our chrome, our platinum, our diamonds. You take that money, our tobacco, you take those, you take that property and use it to fund public goods. That was the ideology of the MDC. That is why it was, its founding Congress was called a Working People's Convention. And we, as socialists and others, were arguing for an even more radical transformation of society.
Mm-hmm.
But we could be able to work together with Changirai, Matongo, and others, together with students like Wende, Hope Ogumbo, Takura Jangaja, Chamisa, because we shared that same ideology. However, today, when you look at the manifesto on which the MDC ran in the 2018 elections, its economic policy is based on what is called ease of doing business. If you look at the resolutions from this Congress, they talk again about realizing the same austerity agenda that ZANU-PF, Mnangagwa and Mthuli are imposing today. Do you realize that the very statement, the very mantra that Mnangagwa runs on today, the mantra of Zimbabwe is open for business, is actually copied from the MDC 2013 manifesto, which was done by Tendai Biti. So, do you realize that the 2% tax that has been imposed by Mthuli against workers, ordinary people, that idea was first mooted and suggested by Ed Cross, the MDC economics guru, in July 2018. The only difference is that Ed Cross was saying it should be 5%. And Ed Cross wanted to change a text that was already there into what then Mthuli has taken. But the opportunism of these people is that that same Ed Cross, who ensured that the MDC ideology was changed from a pro-poor, pro-working people ideology, now to an ideology in which the MDC has become a chikutu of IMF, a chikutu of the West, a chikutu of big business. That same Ed Cross has crossed and now has become an advisor to ED and has been given a contract, a partial contract of running Zisco Steel worth hundreds of millions of dollars.
Mm.
So these are opportunists. They cannot stand for ordinary people and they've changed their ideology. When the MDC was in government under the finance minister of Biti, they ran it under the phrase, we eat what we kill.
Mm.
Now, eat what we kill is simply ISAP, is simply austerity. These people today quoted Biti and they are not.
Mm.
Their grief with Mthuli is that they argue and they say to the West and big business, they will be much better enforcers of ISAP and neoliberalism in this country. So no, this is no longer a party of working people. This is now a party that has been stolen from unions. A party of Iwa, Avachonchele, the Working People's Party.
Mm.
But they used the shell of the party. At one stage, they went away because they were not happy. Because their masters, like the Americans, had said that they did not want Tsvangirai to be used there. But they did not succeed. They come back and they build through. And now we have an ideology of the party that is anti-working people, anti-poor. And there is now no more difference between ZANU-PF and MDC. ZANU-PF, after the coup of November 2017, is now run by a thuggish neoliberal austerity gang.